Hello and welcome to this lesson on gender identity. Here we'll be understanding how does the sense of self and gender identity emerge during childhood years. What is gender? Before we go into the emergence of or the awareness of gender identity, let us first understand what do we mean by gender? What is gender? Can we find gender in these pics? Yes, we can. We can find girls and boys dressed differently in these pics. We can find that the girl in these pictures are wearing ponytails or ribbons on their head. The image on your top left has a girl and a boy. The girl is wearing pink, the boy is wearing blue, which is the color which associated with male and female child. The pic on the bottom right is again a girl and a boy, a little grown-up girl and boy. The girl is seen wearing a frock, whereas the boy is wearing a pair of trousers. One may argue that they were born different. Yes, they were born different. They were born different in terms of their reproductive functioning, which has a purely biological basis. But were they born to wear frocks or pair of trousers? Were they born to wear ponytails? Did nature determine that girls have to wear ponytails? Did nature determine that girls have to wear frocks? Did nature determine that girls have to take care of the kitchen? Did nature determine that women, once they become mothers, have to give more priority to their house and their children rather than their careers? No. The answer is no. Nature or biology created two categories as male and female just on the basis of their reproductive functioning. Rest all, the way we dress up, the way we behave in the presence of others, the way we feel about ourselves, the way we make career choices, the way we give more priority to children, as in the case of women, or to our career, as in the case of men, are all shaped by the culture, by the society we live in. And this is understood as gender, which is socially and culturally shaped. One's sense of feeling like a boy or a girl or like a woman or a man is largely learned as a result of one's interaction with the world. So while being male or female is biologically given, the sense of being a woman or a man, a girl or a boy, is largely dictated or taught to us by the people around with whom we grow up interacting. Now the question is, how do people around us with whom we grow up as children nurture us or shape us in acquiring a sense of gender identity? So one's gender identity is largely shaped by the gender stereotypes which are present in the society and gender roles or the prescriptions of how to feel, think and act for both the sexes. So it is the family or the caregivers or the parents, the immediate environment of the child, which communicates these gender stereotypes or these gender roles to the child knowingly or unknowingly by shaping the choices that children make right from the childhood. You must have observed that girls usually prefer playing with dolls and dollhouses or kitchen sets, and the boys usually prefer playing with guns and cars and trucks. So these are very small things through which, very small choices through which gender roles and gender stereotypes are instilled or taught to the child from a very early age. These gender stereotypes or gender roles can also be observed in the literature or in a given culture or in the cinema or films of a given culture. For understanding it a little more, let us go to a movie clip from the film Mulan, which is based on a Chinese legend.
From the Imperial City. first served the emperor in my father's place.
The Fa family!
No!
This short video clip from the movie Mulan teaches us three things. One, it's the male's job to serve the army. Two, girls should be taught not to use the tongue in front of a man. And three, if a girl does so, it's a matter of dishonor for the entire family. Even though things are changing with technology coming in, things are changing at a very fast pace, but still there are certain gender stereotypes or beliefs about how males and females should be behaving in a particular culture. And these gender stereotypes do operate in every culture. To give you another example, just look at any household where the majority of the household work is the share of the woman and not the man of the house. We have this very strong gendered distribution of work when it comes to running the house. So one's idea of, a child's idea of what it means to be a girl or a boy, what it means to act like a girl or boy, is to a great extent shaped by the social and the cultural values with which parents and the other family members bring up the child. So let us now come to the definitions of gender and gender identity. Gender, as we have already understood, refers to attitudes, feelings, and behavior that a given culture associates with a person's biological sex. Gender identity refers to the image of oneself or one's self-perception of being male or female, generally acquired by the age of 3 years. Having grasped the meaning of gender identity and how it is shaped by the society and the culture we live in, let us now shift our attention to the definitions of gender stereotypes and gender roles. We know what it means, but let us go to the definitions now. Gender stereotypes are widely held beliefs about characteristics of males and females in a particular society or culture. So these are beliefs or notions about what it means to be a male and what it means to be a female in a particular society or culture. Gender roles are prescriptions for males and females on how to think, feel, and behave. So gender roles are prescriptions or do's and don'ts or rules which are laid down by the society, by a specific culture, for males and females on how to behave, think, and feel. Just as we saw in the movie clip from Mulan, Mulan was told by the father again and again not to violate the gender role given to a girl who's not supposed to ask questions in front of a man. And he's reminding the girl again and again to be at her place, which means that she should be behaving in ways which are in consonance with the gender role given by the culture. Those who have seen the movie must be knowing, and those who haven't seen, let me tell you that in this movie later on, Mulan does join the army, but she has to disguise herself as a man because according to the legend, the culture did not permit girls to join the army. It was a man's job. So now that we know the meanings and definitions of terms like gender identity, gender stereotypes, and gender roles, let us now go to the development of gender identity, or how the sense of gender identity develops during early childhood, that is between the age of 2 years and 7 years. Gender identity, as we have understood well, is the image of oneself or one's self-perception of being male or female, generally acquired during childhood. Forming a gender identity is a process that starts off as the child starts interacting with the world around and completes itself only by adolescence. So during the early childhood, a major development which takes place in terms of gender identity is the accomplishment of sex category constancy or a full understanding of the biological permanence of gender. Sex category constancy completes itself in three stages. The first stage is gender labeling, which refers to early preschool children's ability to label their own sex and of others correctly. The second stage is gender stability, where the child is able to have a partial understanding of the permanence of sex as stable over time. So the child understands that a girl grows into a woman and a boy grows into a man. Third stage is the gender constancy stage, where the child is able to understand that sex is biologically based and remains the same even if a person dresses in a cross-gender manner. So before the child has achieved gender constancy, what happens is that if a girl wears a boy's clothes, such as pair of trousers or shorts, the girl child may call herself as having become a boy. Once the child achieves gender constancy, a sense of gender constancy, the child knows that even if he or she dresses in cross-gender ways, it does not change their gender, or they remain the same gender what they are in spite of the clothes which they are wearing. Gender labeling, gender stability, and gender constancy together contribute to a sense of sex category constancy, which means a full understanding of the biologically based permanence of gender. Sex category constancy is usually achieved by the age of 5 years. The late childhood period, or the period between 7 to 11 years of age, is characterized by increased awareness about one's gender identity and an increased identification with the gender stereotypes and gender roles. We know that children also grow cognitively as they develop a sense of gender identity. So their cognition helps them to increase their knowledge about gender stereotypes available to them in their society and culture. And this increased awareness leads to an increased identification with gender roles and stereotypes. Coming to the theoretical viewpoints or theoretical perspectives to gender identity, the first perspective is social learning theory, which assumes that gender identity is acquired as a result of operant conditioning and modeling available to the child. So by virtue of rewarding and punishing certain behaviors, parents, family members, teachers, and others around the child with whom the child interacts instill a sense of gender appropriate behavior by using modeling and reward and punishment. The second theory, or the cognitive development theory, assumes that the gender identity develops in children as a result of developing cognition. So as and when they develop in their cognition, simultaneously their sense of gender identity also increases. The third perspective, which is the gender schema theory, it explains gender awareness or development of gender identity in terms of gender schemas or cognitive frameworks reflecting society's beliefs about gender appropriate roles and behaviors. So according to this view, children process information with the help of these gender schemas. So we have come almost to the end of our series of lectures on physical, cognitive, and socio-emotional development during three developmental stages, that is infancy, childhood, and adolescence. Today we have covered the socio-emotional development, which takes place during childhood, in terms of development of a sense of gender or development of a gender identity. Our next lecture and the last lecture in this series is going to be on development of gender identity during adolescence period. That's all for today's lecture. Thank you.